Thailand, the backpacking and cultural capital of the world. With around 1 million Brits visiting every year.
Hi, Mum.
The country has a lot to offer party-loving tourists. But sometimes paradise comes at a cost. Because compared to any other country in the world, Brits travelling abroad are most likely to get arrested, end up in hospital,
this person could be a big trouble,
or worse. But in Thailand, there's a specialist tourist police force whose job it is to keep them safe.
We try to make everything good for our tourists.
Goodbye, good night.
Because here, trouble comes in all shapes and sizes. Drink.
You're in your hotel.
Thefts.
This is the second time we've been robbed by ladybug.
And the country's infamous sex industry.
We came to Pattaya because we're dirty, dirty boys.
But 2,000 tourist police officers and an army of sidekick volunteers from over 50 different countries
come.
Are there to save the day.
Many times the tourists drinking too much to hang out. We come here for protect tourists.
Welcome to Thailand.
Tonight, one Brit causes chaos on the streets of Bangkok when he's arrested for fighting.
Stop me, let me walk away.
He fights in a stab in the bar.
Fear and loathing in Thailand.
Look,
yeah.
I think you'll go hospital better.
A bloody tourist comes face to face with police when they're called to his hotel.
Hey, he's fast! Don't that where I talk to.
Don't hit me, eh?
And in Bangkok.
We also think this is the same ladyboy that robbed him 14 days ago when we first came to Bangkok.
A pickpocket with a difference.
We went through this road, this side road, and a ladyboy came and grabbed my friend and started touching him all over his body. And he grabbed a phone from his pocket and stole it.
Thailand's capital, Bangkok, is where many tourists start their journey. It's Monday night, and in the centre of the city, 70 officers of the Thai tourist police are on duty, including Officer Off.
Hello.
Hello.
Patrolling all over the city, including the red light district, he's often the first to be called if a tourist ends up in trouble.
Hello, good evening, madam.
Tonight, there are reports of a foreigner causing a violent disturbance a few streets away. Officers on the scene are struggling to control him, and Officer Off's been called to help. Once on the scene, Off needs to find out why the man's being arrested.
He fights in the staff, in the restaurant, in the bar.
And officers are wary about what the man's likely to do.
Okay, he's drunk, be careful.
I'm a fucking winner! What's going on?
He's likely to get a hefty fine for the punch-up in the restaurant, but if he carries on resisting the police, they could lock him up. Officer Off wants to get the situation under control.
It's calm down. Sit down first. Where you come from?
Being manhandled by the police only angers him further.
Fucking rocket!
The smell of alcohol is just too much for one of the officers to stomach.
It's not more. Not more.
It's one way to get the police off your back.
No.
I'm a fucking winner! I'm going home!
Believe me, if you go to outside, they have a problem.
Hey! The drunk Brit makes a break for freedom. But he's not going anywhere.
It's now he's too drunk, cannot control anything. He's talk too bad word to everything is not listen, not stop.
Why did it take
Home is the last place he's heading right now. It's off to the police station where he receives a hefty fine.
Now the policeman, they take him go to the jail because he cannot control anything.
For anyone else, this type of drunken behaviour might put them off Brits Abroad. But not Officer Off.
I love my job too much because I love to help the tourists. You come to another country, you don't know anything, but I'm working here, I help. The tourists happy, me happy too.
To fight crime in Bangkok, Off has to be fully equipped for any situation.
This radio, this gun, and the handcuff.
An entry-level officer in the Thai Tourist Police is paid around £400 per month. From that, they buy their own guns and bullets.
It's my gun. I have everything. Stand by. Because I don't know it's what time we have the case.
Along with go-go bars and full moon parties, in Thailand, hiring a motorbike is a tourist rite of passage. But with more Brits dying on the roads here than in any other country, the cocktail of sun, booze, and two wheels can be fatal. That, however, doesn't seem to worry Mark, who's making the most of his two-week holiday. He's been filling his boots in the local bars.
I've been out all night. I've had about half a bottle of whiskey. Best thing in the world, you can just go out, get on the moped, walk.
Mark's decided to call it a night, and despite being way over the limit, he's also decided it's a really good idea to ride his moped back to the hotel.
I don't think it's illegal. I know it's illegal. Of course it's illegal. It's illegal everywhere you go in the world. Drink driving's illegal everywhere.
If he gets caught, Mark faces being locked up and saddled with a hefty fine. As it happens, when he arrives, his bike is nowhere to be seen.
You said, yes, yes, I look after the bike, I look after the bike. Bike's gone.
In his hurry to hit the bars, Mark decided to ignore the no parking signs and pay a masseuse to keep an eye on it instead.
Have you got a bike here with you to look after?
Mark says he paid the girl £2.50 to watch his bike, and the very least she owes him is an explanation.
Why didn't you look at me when I paid you? Why?
Money, please, not my business.
So I go see police now, yeah?
Yeah, okay, go.
Well, somebody pinched it. Woman out massage parlour comes out. She's like, police, take it. You should not leave it here. I went, why? I give her 100 bucks to watch it. She's like, not my problem. Well, it's not my bike, so I'm not bothered, really.
Coming up, Mark ropes in help from a Brit officer, but doesn't get quite the response he was hoping for.
Don't park your bike illegally.
And a bloody tourist is proving quite a handful.
Don't hit me, eh?
With around 40 million foreign visitors every year, the Thai Tourist Police have to deal with all kinds of problems. Working day and night in every tourist hotspot, from Bangkok to Phuket and Pattaya to Koh Samui, they're here to keep everybody safe. But they do need help. Answering the call, an army of 500 foreign volunteers who give up their free time to help fight crime. 56-year-old Brit David John Smith retired to Thailand 2 years ago. His work as a police volunteer is a world away from what he used to do back home.
I had a company in the UK that used to fit artificial grass. It is completely voluntary. Obviously, we don't get paid any money whatsoever. And you never know what's going to happen when you turn up on duty.
I could really do with a beer right now. A beer would be nice.
We're here really to help people, and that's the idea of it.
Don't get upset, don't get upset.
I think about myself, if I was to come here for the first time and I had a problem and you couldn't speak Thai and you had to go and see someone for help, it's got to be an added bonus to see a tourist police officer.
My friend, you won't spend a night in a prison, promise you. You won't.
I become the friend. That's the first thing I do, and I'm there to help.
Where are you from, my friend?
Tokyo.
Greasing the wheels between the Thai police and the tourists, one key skill is being able to translate.
We have Italian, French, almost every language. I speak 3 languages. We try to help. We communicate with people. To understand, to help people, crazy people sometimes.
You're fine, good, don't worry.
Patrolling the streets of Thailand at night, they need the patience of a saint.
Amazing what people do, what they get up to, always here to help, your first friend.
And someone in need of a friend is tourist Mark.
Hey,
he's drunk half a bottle of whiskey and lost his moped, but he's on a mission to get it back. With the missing bike the only thing standing in the way of him drink-driving his way home, Mark's figured the best plan of action is to ask volunteer tourist police officer David for assistance.
You're not going to get it back tomorrow morning, mate.
Yeah, but I don't know where it is.
You go to the police station, 10 o'clock.
I couldn't do that bike now, even now.
Can't get it now, mate, 10 o'clock tomorrow.
I've got to get a taxi home now.
Well, do you want me to pay for it?
Go on, then. Feel good, back.
Yeah. Jump pay it illegally, mate. That's all it is. 10 o'clock tomorrow, you need the bike details, you'll get it, you have to pay a fine. Don't park your bike illegally. Otherwise,
no,
it gets taken.
I didn't think it was illegally.
Well, unfortunately, it was. So nothing we can do.
For a 300 baht or £7 taxi fare, Mark could call it a night and get home safely. But that would be much too easy.
I need that bike, man. I've only just put £2 worth of juice in it today as well.
Unwilling to let the matter go, Mark ignores David's advice and heads back to the scene of the crime.
Where is my bike?
It's not my business.
I paid the woman 100 baht. No, let me buy it go as well. Let me buy it go.
I tell you, everybody tell you cannot
you
pack
shit.
It.
No wonder
I tell you, everybody cannot pack it.
Fed up with his complaints, the massage girl stops a passing traffic policeman to see if he can help.
I have a motorbike here. She says she looked after it. What? I pay her 100 baht and police take the bike. I don't know where police station is.
The police station isn't open until tomorrow morning, and that's not soon enough for our Mark.
You get my motorbike now for me, I'll give you 1,000 baht. You get my bike now, I'll give you 1,000 baht.
1,000 baht is about £25, 3 times as much as it would cost him to get a taxi home. But Mark is convinced he's onto a winner.
Talk to her. Go on, my man, do your thing, Romeo. He's all right in this copper, he's all right. That's what I'm going to give him. If he can get me my bike back now, can't be arse waiting about. I want to go and have 5 more sambucas and I want to go home.
Hearing of the continued commotion, volunteer David has been called from Walking Street to help resolve the situation once and for all.
Mate, it's not up to the massage girl to say whether you can park or not.
Yeah, but she said, yeah, but you park. I said, he's under the bat, no problemo.
You can't do it, mate.
Well, she said I could.
Whatever you say to her, whatever you do, doesn't make it. You will not get your back any quicker.
Oh, you're English.
I am English.
So you're my side then. What are you on their side?
I'm not on their side. What I'm trying to say to you, if you start kicking off, they're just going to light you up. So what do you want me to do? What do you want me to do? Do you want
me to get back?
Well, tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock.
Fuck it, I'll have to go home.
Yeah.
Finally, Mark accepts the inevitable.
Mate, get yourself home, yeah? Do us a favour.
Yeah?
Top man.
Hey, thank you.
Right.
Luckily for Mark and everyone else, he's not drink driving his way home tonight.
This is how illegal Thailand is. No helmet, no helmet.
Kilometres southeast of Bangkok is the city of Pattaya, a beach resort with a reputation amongst British travellers. Since American soldiers first visited the city during the Vietnam War, its popularity has grown thanks in part to a thriving sex industry.
Welcome to Pattaya!
I'm reporting live from Thailand. I'm exposing the sex trade for what it is. You know, follow me to the bars. Let's go, come on.
Home to over 1,000 bars and massage parlours and some 27,000 sex workers, it's estimated a million men visit the city's red light district each year.
It's like nothing you've ever seen in the whole world before. People are selling sex everywhere. You can't go anywhere in England and find British women doing this openly and freely like this than you will Thai ladies. But if they stopped all this in Thailand, would they have the money, would they have the tourism? That's the problem. This is what attracts the people here. The
tourists come here with a lot of money to spend, so they make the most of it.
Although prostitution is illegal, that doesn't stop Thailand's tourists enjoying themselves.
Just the whole scene of Pattaya is crazy. I'm coming here on holiday for cheap beer, cheap clubbing, and cheap fucking you-know-what.
Walking Street is lined with strip clubs and girls touting their services to eager tourists. In Pattaya, it seems anything goes.
Going hard for that trophy is what they all been on me.
Here for Ladyboys, good time, long time, short time. We've tag teamed the Ladyboy. We've done some things that we are not proud of, but live once, no regrets, you know what I mean?
So this is us getting sucked off by a Ladyboy. And look, he just pops up.
Call the Ladyboy, Steve-O.
Yeah, Steve-O, that's our Ladyboy.
Steve-O's a good bloke.
Oh, I'm not gay, but I guess a bloke knows what a bloke wants when he comes to Thailand, fuck
you. I didn't wear a Johnny, I just went bareback. My mum wouldn't be impressed, let me tell you. You're a naughty boy, Jeffrey, you're a naughty boy.
And a very silly one, Jeffrey. Very silly. It's Saturday night and Belgian-born tourist police volunteer Freddy is on shift.
It's crazy.
I know it.
It's the busiest night of the week and the place is heaving with tourists out for a good time. But in Pattaya, it's easy to have too much of a good time. A staff member from a nearby hotel has come to the tourist police desk to report a serious incident involving one of their guests. A man was seen collapsed in the street.
The hotel manager came to the desk and tell us about he injured the face and fall down here. And we go look in the hotel here.
The injured man returned to the hotel a few minutes ago and was last seen heading to his bedroom covered in blood.
Oh, okay.
Where are you from, sir?
Switzerland.
What happened?
I want to sleep.
You look.
Yeah.
I think you'll go to hospital better.
No.
The tourist was on his way back from a bar when he tripped and fell. In his drunken state, he's oblivious to the extent of his injuries.
Look in the mirror.
Yeah.
Look your face.
Oh!
Not doing with your hand, okay?
Too much blood.
You have plastic?
A sticker.
I cannot touch you. I don't have a plastic. Here, take more. Look.
Dazed and confused, Freddy can't leave him like this. But without protective plastic gloves, he can't tend to the wound himself either. So he's called for a medic.
Ooh. What do you want?
The people come from the rescue and clean your face.
Yeah.
Okay?
Here.
No, he want you go downstairs. That's and there. After you can come back.
What do you mean downstairs?
In the lobby.
The hotel wants the man downstairs so he doesn't get blood over the bed. But all he wants to do is go to sleep.
You cannot go to bed, don't he charge you money for this? Yeah. Come with us downstairs, clean your face, and everything okay. Then you come back and you can come to sleep, okay?
Yeah.
Come. Yeah. Come with us. You go clean your face downstairs.
Okay.
Come.
Bob!
Eventually, Freddy manages to persuade him to come downstairs.
No.
What do you want?
You come with us.
No!
Yes.
But he's not happy.
What do you want?
Sit down.
Hey!
Yeah, you cannot go sleep like this. Okay, thank you. You want water?
No.
In reception, whether it's the language barrier, the alcohol, or the blow to his head, the injured tourist has had enough.
No, sit down.
What?
Wait.
The key, Dan!
Okay. Rescue come and clean your face. Okay?
Yeah, here. Hang up on the door.
You know one will help you?
Door.
Come now.
Boss, I need the key.
Here, your key.
Okay, here. Boss.
Don't hit me, eh?
Boss.
Okay.
The key.
Okay.
The key.
You come now.
Yeah, the key.
You want to help
there.
Me?
Being prevented from returning to his room is stressing the man out. And he's becoming more and more aggressive.
Up to him.
Back home.
Okay, he don't want to help, okay.
Get back the key.
In the end, Freddy decides it's safer to allow him to go back upstairs.
We try to help, okay. You see, drunk people, but we can do nothing.
10 minutes later, the medic finally arrives.
Long time, man.
And he's all ears to hear of the patient.
Sir?
Come back. Yeah,
this is you. Clean your face.
It's you.
Okay, you sit down. Okay,
down.
Being back in his room has helped calm the man down. While he receives treatment, details of the big night out begin to emerge.
You feel dizzy?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I drunk. Tapuka. Tapuka. Peppermint.
You got peppermint?
Beach club. Happy hour, go.
Happy hour.
No wonder he wasn't feeling any pain. But if he doesn't have a sore head now, he will do in the morning.
When you feel you're not good tomorrow, go see a doctor, okay? Take care, my friend. Yeah. Okay?
Okay.
Take care, bye-bye.
Thank you.
You spend a lot of money, are you drinking alcohol? A lot? No, okay, you go sleep now. Tomorrow maybe you go again.
With the man bandaged up and out of harm's way, it's case closed for Freddy. Coming up, officers find a woman in trouble on the street.
Not help me.
Calm.
No eating, no sleeping.
In the party capital of Pattaya, Officer Seed of the Thai Tourist Police is beginning the night shift. His normal beat is the rowdy walking street.
I have to deal with the drunk people because walking street is all nightclub.
This is me!
Yeah, it's like funny, but sometimes, you know, it's not easy to work as well.
Helping him keep the mayhem under control is police volunteer David.
Seed, he's a really good guy, very streetwise, and we work quite well as a team. I go in to negotiate. I'm the good guy. He can be the bad guy if he needs to be. But his tolerance is good. He can read into a lot of people that are not the right people on the street.
It's a skill Seed's developed over his 5 years on the job.
And many times when they stop this car or person, they will have some things, you know, problem. Like sometimes they may hide drugs, or maybe they have the mental cycle problem.
At 9 o'clock, Seed spots someone he's concerned about. He and David approach.
You speak English?
Yes.
What's your problem?
I have a boyfriend, Nasha, inside. He from Arab.
Yeah.
He after 2 hours go Dubai. He take money after go hospital. I call, he not answer back. Man. I tell you.
Arab couple, just fell out with a boyfriend. Doesn't want to be with her. She's got no money. She's trying to get us to get him outside.
Not help me.
Okay.
Calm. No eating, no sleeping.
Okay.
I sometimes gym.
Where is your boyfriend now?
Inside Nasha.
Yes. So how I can help you because your boyfriend doesn't want to talk to speak with you?
No, give money for me. He go Dubai.
And I cannot talk about money. You have to talk by yourself.
Your husband doesn't want to speak to you. When was the last time you spoke to your husband?
Inside now. Maybe after 30 minutes he go, I...
With the threat of her becoming abandoned and penniless in Thailand, Seed wants to know more about who this woman is.
Can I see your passport, please?
No.
May I see your passport, please?
You need to see your passport.
No.
To make sure you have visa to be in country.
I have a visa.
But we need to see it.
Yes, visa.
We need to see.
Okay. Tajikistan.
Even though the documents are in order, Seed's sure there's more to it than this. A background check confirms his suspicions.
She has been staying in the police station about 2 or 3 days. The press told me that she had a mental problem. Yeah.
Getting her under expert care in hospital is now Seed's primary objective.
Okay, you need to go hospital, right?
Ambulance.
Yes, we call ambulance for you already. Yeah. Just come down, okay? You wait here.
Quick.
We call ambulance for you already.
Quick.
We are.
Quick. Please, quick.
She may seem eager to accept the help, but her panicked state means she's quickly changing her mind.
I go now see boyfriend. Maybe,
sure?
Yeah, maybe he's going.
Just hold on a sec. Seed?
Yeah.
Seed, just come here a sec. She wants to go and see her boyfriend.
See her boyfriend?
Yeah. You got to get her to the hospital. I'm trying to get her to the hospital. But she's gone back in the thing to see her boyfriend. She shouldn't be allowed to travel. She's got issues like that. There's no way she should be traveling. Yeah.
We understand, but we cannot keep any pressure with your boyfriend. Do you have a mobile phone number of your boyfriend?
Yes, now close. Inside too much music, not upstairs.
Okay, you wait here, okay?
Not a moment too soon. The ambulance arrives and Seed's able to get her the help she needs.
You go with ambulance to a hospital, okay?
Yeah, ambulance come, no problem.
Despite being a volunteer for 2 years, some cases can still catch David off guard.
Surprised me, I've never seen that before. What you think is just going to be a simple thing, arguing with your boyfriend, next thing you find out she's got psychological problems. She spent 2 or 3 days in the police station already, trying to get into the hospital to get some treatment. Every day is a different day. A different day in paradise.
Let's go.
For now at least, the woman is heading to hospital where she can get the help she needs. And David and Seed can continue their patrol.
My plaster has come off my blister.
When those travelling on a budget hit Bangkok, they head straight for the famous Khao San Road.
I come here now 8 years in a row, so Khao San Road is the best.
Once described as the centre of the backpacking universe, it's developed a reputation for attracting soul-searching tourists, amazing street food, low-rent accommodation, and cheap booze.
Buckets and Jag, that's what it's all about.
Good street food.
Yeah, absolutely. Scorpion spider.
Pad thai.
But it's the road with a split personality.
This time of day, it's about trying to sell you suits and trinkets, but come here at night time and it's about making yourself deaf and drunk.
It's just madness.
At night it comes alive and you get lost. Have you seen The Hangover? It's exactly like that.
Bangkok as you know.
Despite the laid-back atmosphere during the daytime, Khao San Road shows its teeth at night, when bar fights, pickpockets, and prostitution are rife.
Khao San Road is the place where like the freshers come when they first arrive in Bangkok. They come and have a few drinks here. This is a cheap night out. You can get the cheapest drinks in Bangkok.
First time in Thailand, I'd recommend it to anybody. It's good crack, it's good fun.
Patrolling these mean streets, Officer Off has seen it all.
The number one crime in here for the stealing, because sometimes the tourists coming and drinking too much, it's too easy for somebody to steal. Sometimes I go to the bar and sit down and wait to looking for the scam.
Sometimes Off gets lucky and catches the thieves in the act. Others, they're long gone by the time he gets involved. And on the Khao San Road, Off never needs to wait too long for a case.
You come together?
Yeah.
Three Slovenian men have reported a theft from the night before.
This is the first time you lost a wallet and mobile phone.
We were outside partying around 3 a.m. in the morning. We went for this road, this side road, and a ladyboy came and grabbed my friend and started touching him all over his body. And he grabbed a phone from his pocket and stole it.
Their only evidence is a photograph they managed to take of the suspected thief.
We also think this is the same ladyboy that robbed him 14 days ago when we first came to Bangkok.
Yes.
Yeah. They took his phone and also wallet. We went out to party. We got separated, and he fell asleep like for 5 minutes. I don't know. He doesn't remember where. And when he woke up, his wallet and his phone was missing.
This is the second time.
Yeah, probably.
While the Slovenians cancel their credit cards, Officer Off is hot on the trail of the pickpocket.
The soil and the check to the CCTV, I hope to find this lady boy. I want to know what happened.
Off knows these streets like the back of his hand and is sure there's a bar backing onto the alley.
I want to go to inside first. I want to check to the CCTV and ask to some people inside.
The manager shows Off into the alley behind the bar.
Here they have the CCTV. I hope this CCTV can tell me what happened here. This what time did somebody steal you?
2 to 3 a.m.
Okay.
Just as Off's plans seem to be paying off, it's dealt a sudden body blow.
This bar they have to the one CCTV, but I'm talking to the one guy and this bar already. It's not working. Unlucky.
For now, the ladyboy mugger has got lucky.
Could you give me to the email and address? Right.
But Officer Off isn't ready to give up on the case.
I can find to your wallet and the mobile phone. I contact you in this email, okay?
Okay.
Everything, right. Yes. Okay, yes. Yes, now you can go back.
...80 kilometers southeast of Bangkok, Seed and David are back pounding the beat in Pattaya.
had the cards up there, don't we?
It's been 4 days since they took a woman with mental health problems to hospital. But 2 hours into the shift, they come across her again.
Don't worry. I will take your
hand. I am okay.
She's saying her boyfriend has dumped her. And now, in a fit of rage, she wants him arrested.
Here, they're in there right now. White collar.
Okay, let's have it.
No, now.
I can't hold you now.
Hospital.
The manager of a nearby nightclub has called the police, complaining that she's been attacking his customers.
She has some idea, like her boyfriend is inside, so she went inside. She had a fight with somebody, so we took her out. She is doing nasty stuff. She is throwing coconut or some bottle, you know, on people. And she is fighting with the security. And we are trying to tell police every day, just take her away. We don't want problems here with customers, you know.
Knowing she's unwell and vulnerable, Seed again wants to get her off the street and to safety.
The lady, she had a problem with the mental. I think last time we take her to hospital and maybe she ran away from the hospital. So we have to take her to back to hospital again. I will take you to hospital, okay?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah. I am okay, yeah.
Okay, I will take you to hospital.
Yeah,
okay.
I know.
In a bizarre twist, they discover she's carrying around all of her possessions.
Where do you take everything here?
Yeah. My hotel room. No problem. People, not safely. Take money, this country.
What is?
My
gross.
Passport.
So when you go back to your country?
It's after I go Qatar, Emirates.
Yeah. Okay, I go with you, okay? Yeah. Yeah. Okay, come.
After Kedic.
I will come here. Do you trust me? Okay, I'm Muslim. Assalamu alaikum. We have the same religion, okay?
Yeah.
We come to help you, okay?
Okay.
So.
The tourist police have to be trained to deal with many different situations to work on the streets of Pattaya.
When we work with the person who have the mental problem, we have to be very honest, very kind. So that's why I try to speak with her very polite, you know, and try to make her like a friend. And she feels more comfortable, you know, to go with me to hospital.
In the end, the woman goes quietly, and the police have ensured that nightclub is safe for other tourists to enjoy.
Tourist police are very nice here. They are very helpful, you know. They came here now. We called them, we sent our staff there. So they came here and now maybe they resolve the problem, we think.
Seed's job is done. He can only hope this time she does get well enough to finally return home. Coming up, on the hunt for a light-fingered thief.
This case, I cannot sleep.
Hello.
In Bangkok, it's a week since three Slovenian men fell victim to a pickpocket for the second time.
This is the same ladyboy that robbed him 14 days ago when we first came to Bangkok.
To you and me, it might only be a missing wallet and phone, but to Officer Off, it's a whole lot more.
This case, I cannot sleep. It's on every night. I want to find him. If I'm lucky, I can find a ladyboy.
So tonight, he's working undercover, hoping to track the thief down on an old-fashioned stakeout.
I want to go to the bar, I want to check. If the lady boy come to Khao San Road, the lady boy go to the bar.
It's like finding a needle in a haystack.
Tonight is many people, because this night is Friday night. We have to the many tourists come to here to the drinking and dinner too much.
An hour later, there's still no sign of the light-fingered lady.
Usually, every time they have the ready boy, where? In this area. But now, I'm not find him.
Officer Off turns to his network of contacts to help track her down.
This is my friend. You got this. This is my friend. And what happened here, I can talk with my friend. This is my friend, can tell me everything.
Welcome to Thailand.
We have a security. Another share.
Good man, really good man, really good guy. You have friends a lot around here?
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot. The best friend to me. Yeah.
ต้องสวัสดีครับ
สวัสดีครับสวัสดีครับ
เพราะว่ามันมีผมให้ดูรูปแล้วก็สมมติว่าเจอ
ใช่
รบกวนเดี๋ยวโทรหาผมหน่อย
ได้เหมือนเดิมเดี๋ยวผมบอกให
้ได้ได้ขอบคุณมาก
เจอนะเพราะผมอยู่แถวนี้ประจำอย
ู่ได้ได้ขอบคุณมากนะครับผมครับ
สวัสดีครับสวัสดีครับ
I'm talk with my friend it's the last time I'm show to the picture at the lady boy if he saw the lady boy he called to with me
running out of options off has just one last roll of the dice
ก็คือจริงๆแล้วตรงนี้เขาบอกว่าทางนักท่องเที่ยวเนี่ยเดินมา3คนแล้วทีนี้ก็มีกระเทยนะครับคนในรูปเนี่ยเขาได้มาล้วงเนี่ยในซอยในซอยโอเคครับขอบคุณมากครับพี่ครับ
This bar is next to the alley where the men were robbed and is a popular thoroughfare for ladyboys on the Khao San Road If he's going to see her anywhere it'll be here
I want to sit down here at this bar. I want to wait. If I'm lucky, to have some lady boy walk into this store to out to the Khao San Road.
An hour later, Off finally accepts defeat.
I'm sit down on the bar for a long time, but I'm not fine. I think that lady boy know already. You have the police come to find. I think it's so difficult because if the lady boy still did not come back again for this time.
3 weeks later, the case is closed. But sadly, without finding the thief or the missing phone and wallet. In the hedonistic beach resort of Pattaya, it's business as usual for Officer Seed and his team. They've been called to a disturbance at a bar on Walking Street where a tourist was out having a good time and just didn't know when to stop. It's down to Officer Seed to calm the situation and move the man on. Happy hour may be over, but the man is determined to get another drink. Slapping a police officer is a surefire way of ending your evening.
This guy is very drunk and very aggressive. And we have to take care of other tourists because they might make a trouble to other tourists.
Seed takes the man to the police pickup to decide what to do with him. Then, just as Seed seems to be making friends, now that's going to really cost him. Arrested for being drunk and disorderly, the man's big night out looks like it's ending badly, sleeping it off in the local police cells. Next time, Operation X-Ray Outlaw Foreigner sees mass tourist arrests in Bangkok.
We scan, we search, we hunt.
An Irish man is panicking after losing 10 grand of valuables.
I know life's not fair, but Jesus, everything's in that bag.
And police are called to help a holidaymaker.
Excuse me.
Who's no idea where he is or what he's been doing.
I don't know what happened to me when I come from Kuwait.
Look at the ice. He is under the power of some drugs.
Catch all that new next Monday at 10.
It's home to some of America's most dangerous women. Get a glimpse of jailbird life with new Bad Girls behind bars at 10 tomorrow. And tonight, what's it like growing up under the big top? Meet the circus kids living the dream as we go inside their secret world next.